with the picture of me jumping off that little thing. And the cameraman, his face, he's looking at me like he's gonna fucking kill me. And I realized that he probably had every right to do so. And I've never seen him since. And always wondered, and I see this thing in the hallway and the house, so I kind of remind it every day, and I wonder, like, whatever happened to that guy? Is he still pissed off at me? And so when we were in Amsterdam the other night, I met a local, and I said, is there any way we can find him? And we did, and then. So congratulations on that, job well done. But here's the thing, he told me a completely different story than what I've had in my head all these years, and I'll tell it quick, because, you know, when I thought he was so angry at me, and what he was doing was, the if I were to jump on that thing, he had to get other guys to hold the bat, the ballast, otherwise I would have jumped on and we just would have gone down. So he's yelling at things, he's not yelling at me, he's yelling to get other guys to hold us up. So then we go off to the front and we're almost over the crowd, but not quite. And then when I try to make it, which I felt like I was going to be about that short and forever be this short, he was yelling. When he's yelling, he's not yelling at me. He's yelling at the mic for the guys to jump off the back, because once I jump, he would have gone shooting in the fucking atmosphere. So the whole time, this guy, we were working in tandem, but we had no clue whatsoever. He hasn't been angry at me this whole time, and I just feel so fucking forgiven. That is a great feeling, and I've been waiting so long.